हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एसओपी एकेडमी। सो देयर इज अ गुड न्यूज़ फॉर द 2019 एंड 2020 बैच ग्रेजुएट्स। कैपजेमिनी हैज ऑफिशियली स्टार्टेड हायरिंग अगेन फॉर दीज टू बैचेस। सो द ड्राइव इज नोन एज कैपजेमिनी एक्सेलर ऑफ कैंपस ड्राइव। दिस इज द कैरियर्स पेज ऑफ कैपजेमिनी। द लिंक फॉर दिस वेबसाइट इज गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। यू कैन क्लिक ऑन द लिंक एंड अप्लाई। सो वी विल लुक इन डिटेल द एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया एंड हाउ टू अप्लाई। सो फर्स्ट लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया। As you can see, the batches of 2019 and 2020 will be eligible from these qualifications, which is MCA, BE BTech. It will be open for all branches. If you are from mechanical, electrical, civil, ECE, CSIT, all branches will be eligible for both BE, that is Bachelors of Engineering, and BTech also. So apart from MCA, BE and BTech, ME and MTech will be eligible, but from only IT stream, Information Science stream and Computer Science stream. So in ME MTech only three stream branches are eligible, but in MCA, BE, BTech all branches will be eligible. The percentage criteria, as you have seen in the thumbnail, is only 50% this time in your diploma graduation, which is aggregate of 8 semesters as well as MCA. So in MCA there are only 6 semesters, so it will be an aggregate of 6 semesters. The candidate should not have more than 1 year of gap, so only 1 year of gap will be allowed after the education. So the academic milestone stages considered are 10th, 12th degree and post graduation. Candidate should not have any gap within an academic milestone. So the academic milestone, as you can see, is 10th, 12th degree and post graduation. You can have after the milestone, but you cannot have any gap within an academic milestone. Then candidate appeared for 12th twice will be considered, provided both the mark sheets are available. So if you have given 12th for improvement, or you have failed the first time and then again you gave your 12th, then you must have both the mark sheets at the time of documentation. The second thing is, candidate choosing degree after diploma should not have any gaps between diploma and degree. So those people who have done diploma as well, then you should not have any gap between the diploma and your degree. Candidate shouldn't have taken more than 4 years. So you should have taken 4 years to complete your BE BTech, and should not have any backlog at time of the process, appearing for the process. So when you will be giving the exam, you should not have any backlogs at that time. Must be flexible to relocate at any Capgemini location, work across technology, domain, role, and should be ready to work in shifts if required. So you can be sent to any location, any time shift can be given to you, any domain or any role can also be given. Should be open to sign service level agreement. So as you all know that Capgemini has 2 year of agreement and a bond of 2 lakh rupees. So you must be ready to sign the bond, and only shortlisted candidates will be invited for the test or assessment selection process. So after you apply for this drive, then everyone will not be given the test link, but those who are eligible and are shortlisted for the drive, only those people will get the link for the drive in their email IDs. The last thing is, entire selection process from test to interview will be done in virtual mode. So everything is online. The last date, as you can see, to apply for this drive will be January 9th. So you have 6 more days to apply. The test for assessment for registered students will begin from January 14th. So January 9th is the last day, and from January 14th, the test will start. If you don't know about the assessment process, then it is as follows. There will be 5 steps overall. The first 4 steps are the online assessment, which will have first section, which is technical assessment pseudocode. The second will be multiple choice questions in English communication test. Third will be a game based aptitude test, and fourth will be a behavioral competency profiling. This is not an elimination round, but other 3 are elimination round. So if you are eliminated in the first round itself, you will not be able to go to the next round. So you have to qualify each and every round to go to the next round. But step 4, that is behavioral round, is not elimination round. After you clear the online assessment, you will get a link for your technical and HR interview. After you clear your technical and HR, you will be given an LOI. So only those clients who have cleared test assessment from step 1 and step 2 will be invited for the interview. One thing to note, that is many students have a doubt which they have clarified this time, is that receiving the work style report does not confirm the clearance of test assessment. So if you get the behavioral competency profiling, when you give the behavioral round, after the assessments are done, then some people receive the work style report, which is just a shadow, or you can say your behavioral profile module. So it does not mean that you are selected. Only after you get a mail for selection for the interviews, then only you can think that you are selected. To apply, simply click on register now. So this page will open up. This is a Superset platform. So Capgemini hires every year through Superset platform only. So when you click on join now, you will come on to this page. You can see all the things that I have already discussed are mentioned here. You will get a package of 3 LPA. The job function is engineering, web or software. The last date as already mentioned. The eligibility criteria I have already discussed with you. To apply, you simply have to click on apply now. So when you click on apply now, this pop-up icon comes up. So what you have to do, if you already have an account in Superset, you have to enter your email address. And if it is already on Superset, then you can simply log in. If you don't have, then let me put some email ID and click on next. Then it will say, please click on register and apply below. So you will have to click on register and apply. After that, you will fill all these details, basic details, contact details, your education details, internship details, profile photo and documents. You will add your resume also. Then you will submit it. After that, you can simply come to that page and apply. So I hope you understand each and every point in this video. If you come across any doubt or any query, then you can ask in the comment section. So I will help you all. So that is all for this video. See you soon in the next one.